up here? Franky? Franky?
What the hell do you want?
Look. Church service must be just about over by now.
So what?
Everyone will be coming out soon.
You keep away from me!
Doyle! What the hell are you doing? Come down from there! And you too, Travers!
What's she doing?
What's it look like?
Nobody moves.
Oh, is she gonna jump me?
Oh, I don't know. Will you stop pouring me, Doreen?
Oh, I don't wanna look!
You got yourself quite an audience down there. Is that what you wanted? You don't care, do you? I guess today you don't care much about anything. But that'll pass, Franky.
What would you know?
Look, I know about your brother, but really, this isn't going to help.
What will, smartass?
I don't know. You just got to go on, that's all. You think Gary would have wanted to see you like this?
Right, Doyle. I think this has gone far enough.
Get away. I mean it.
Inside, please, Miss Bennett.
Bitch Bennett. Think she's so tough. She only thinks she's tough. Cream puff.
You're the one that's really tough, right? Franky Doyle. The real boss of the place,
and it's
true. Well, you're not acting so tough today. I thought you were the one that your brother looked up to, the one that he needed. And here you are prancing round on the roof, cracking up. Well, I reckon you're piss weak, Franky.
You can't talk to me like that.
What are you gonna do?
Nothing. Bloody nothing.
What a piker! Fearless Franky can't take it! Franky! Franky!
He was only doing it for me.
Bugger got himself flattened by a dresser. For me, his stomach's of a sister who can't even read. He was waiting for me at the hospital. He died on his own. Because his stomach's of a sister can't even read.
Old hole. Franky certainly makes a mess of everything.
She would have if she jumped. You know, I've never seen anyone jump off a roof before. Must make a hell of a mess.
You'd like to have seen that, would you, Doreen?
Oh, nah, I was just curious.
Gosh, she wasn't going to jump anyway.
She might have. She might have. She's a desperate woman. And even if she didn't jump off the roof, she might still go over the wall. They're mending the outer fences, and there are bits down everywhere if she want to escape. We could go over the fence near the garden.
We? Oh, so you'd be going with her, would you?
Yeah, I would.
You don't know when you're well off, Lizzie.
I know when I'm bad off. She's no help. She's worthless.
Oh, well, at least I've got ideas. What have you got?
Guts.
Oh, yeah, and see how far that gets you.
Thank you. To put an end to any speculation about Franky Doyle, she's now quiet and resting.
Yeah. In solitary, I'll bet.
Yes, Marilyn. That's right.
Dr. Miller's arrived.
Carry on, girls. There's nothing to worry about. Quiet and resting. They probably hit her over the head. I don't know. I think Franky had the right idea.
Oh, Marilyn, really?
Well...
Don't you start feeling sorry for yourself. You've got no one else to blame for being back in here.
I can't help it if Vera's picking on me.
You can soon stop that. Why don't you tell her copper boyfriend what he wants to know?
Because...
Ah, because. Get smart, Marilyn.
Good afternoon, Sergeant.
Yeah, right. Well, how are you?
Oh, my afternoon's just got brighter.
Yeah?
And on a Sunday, too.
Oh, yeah.
It seems like such a long time since our Friday evening. I really enjoyed myself.
Oh, yeah, me too. Well, that was some meal you cooked. We'll have to do it again sometime.
Just say when.
Yeah, right. Well, really good to see you. I was just wondering, though, since I'm here, you know, how are you getting on with Mason? Yeah. Little tart won't crack, eh? I mean, you promised you'd help me, Vera.
I'm riding her hard. Look, she's a tough one, Graham.
Yeah, but I've taken your word for it. I mean, I've stuck my neck out in this one. And it's drugs, a big time right now.
I know. Look, she'll crack. I promise. I won't let you down, Graham.
No. Yeah, sure. I know you're doing your best.
You wanted to see me?
Just seen Franky, given her a mild sedative.
That's the name of the game, isn't it? A mild sedative. She needs more than that.
Yes, I agree. I also think you could do something to help.
Me?
She trusts you. You were the one on the roof.
The way the screws were carrying on, they might as well have pushed her.
That puts you in a special position to help her.
Why me? You're the one that's paid to help.
Karen, why are you so hostile?
Why are you evading the issue? You know as well as I do that if we got some decent rehabilitation programs in here, a few less might come back the week after they get out. You people are all the same.
What's this you people? You think I'm in
cahoots? Yes, that's right. To us, you're one of them.
That way of thinking is precisely why we people get nowhere. Them and us are never the twain shall meet. Anyone trying to help is regarded with suspicion, hostility...
What do you expect after that master's woman?
Oh, that's a very good excuse for doing absolutely nothing, isn't it? Franky Doyle can't read. You could teach her.
Why should I?
Why shouldn't you? You talked her out of killing herself. You might spare a thought for where she goes from here. After all, none of we people are going to help.
Very clever. What a telling thrust.
Yes, I thought so. While you're groping for a cynical reply, you might have a look at these.
They're mine. Where'd you get them?
From your old school.
I didn't think I'd ever see them again.
No, Karen. You decided you wouldn't see them again.
Okay, I know you've had a long hike with the little one and...
Oh, I'll be all right.
Sure you will. Look, well, get inside. You can put your feet up, all right? Have a bit of a rest.
Yeah.
What's wrong?
Well, are you sure this is all right? I mean, I know you said Bernie was a friend of yours and everything, but just lobbing in like this...
No worries. Look, just watch. G'day, Vernie, how are you?
Doug Parker, you old bastard. I thought you was inside.
Yeah, they let me out. I'm on holidays now. We happen to be in the district and...
Oh, yeah. Short of a dollar, are you? Yeah, not to worry. Go on, get inside. Anyone we know?
Yeah, come on, Lynn. No, don't hang back. She's right there. Vernie, this is Lynn. We're together.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, not a bad little shack.
Yeah, not bad, not bad. Well, make yourselves at home, eh? Oh, I'd like you to meet Susie, Doug and,
Lynn.
There you go, Lynn.
Hi.
Pleased to meet you.
Just park yourself anywhere, Lynn. No standing on ceremony here. Me and Susie have been shacked up for... How long is it, Dale?
4 months.
Yeah. Didn't think we'd met.
You was inside, you nog. You want a beer?
There.
Got one in the oven.
Which?
Oh, happens to the best of us.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Tell you what, Lynn. Oh, geez, I'm sorry. Do you want
to...
Right. Yeah, me and old Dougie here, we go back a long way.
A long way.
And you should have remembered that, old son. Pulling a job on your own. Reckoned you could get along without me, eh?
What, I was wrong, was I?
Of course. Next job together, right?
Jeez. As if you never got caught. Listen to them, bloody masterminds.
Oh, come off it, Suze. Give a man a go in his own home.
Pour us a drink. Franky, you awake?
Hmm.
Are you awake?
No. Rack off.
It's Karen Travers.
The Scrooge little doll. What'd you tell him about me?
I didn't come here to fight with you.
What did you come here for then? You're gonna give us a kiss? That is, if you can get through the door your mates have locked on me.
Listen, how would you like me to teach you to read?
And the rest.
No, I mean it.
Yeah.
I know how bad you feel about it, but we could...
Don't do me any favours, you snotty little snob. Who needs your reading?
You do.
Leave me alone. Go on. You give me the creeps, the lot is. Get back to the screws where you belong.
Well, don't worry about that, Lenny, love. We'll do it in the morning. Hey, why don't we sing a few more songs, eh? Why don't we, eh?
Because we're going to bed.
Yeah, it suits me. I've had it.
Bloody good idea.
You'll be lucky if you can walk in there, let alone... You two can have the spare room, okay? There's a double in there.
That's fine with us.
Doug? But Doug, what? Doesn't look like you've been so shy of the look of that tummy of yours.
Please, Doug.
Yeah, look, lay off, Suze. There's no reason you'd know this, but... Lenny got herself raped. The kid's not mine.
Oh, poor little thing.
Well, you start all kinds of ways. Tell you, Lenny, my first time, the only reason it wasn't rape was that I said yes.
Right, lay off, Suze. Lynn's not that sort of girl.
What sort of girl is she, eh?
It's his problem. We're going to bed. Good night, lovebirds.
She didn't mean anything.
Why did we have to come here?
Eh?
And you're drunk.
Yeah, that doesn't mean I don't love you. Now, why don't we go to bed and have a bit of a cuddle?
No, I said no and I mean it. Not until we're married.
Oh, come off it, Lynn. What are you trying to prove?
No! Dad?
Yeah, what?
Oh, look, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to embarrass you in front of your friends. It's just, you've got to let me do what I think's right.
You're just the same, Lynn. You're already...
No, I said no, and I'm not changing my mind. Anyway, I still love you.
Yeah, me too.
Night.
Night.
Thank you.
Done a bit of reading, eh?
That's right.
Reckon you can teach me? U V W X Y Z.
Good, you certainly know the alphabet.
Yeah, but that's not real reading, is it?
Well, would you like to try some words?
Yeah, all right.
Okay. That's a good one. Right.
These are kids' books.
Well, would you like to start on maybe a newspaper?
No, this'll do. Oh, geez, how does anyone do this? Right, Bob is a boy.
Yeah.
Bob has a dog. I don't know, that's a long word.
Well, what if we cover up this letter here and these two at the end? That leaves us with?
All.
Right, and all together that makes?
So called. Bob has a dog called Jip. Bloody stupid name for a dog. Jill is a girl. Jill.
Hey, have a guess what I just saw. Karen's teaching Franky to read.
No, that'll be nice for them.
To read? I thought everyone could read.
Not everyone's had your advantages, love.
God, that'll be the end of her. She won't be desperate no more. And then how am I going to get out of here?
Maybe she'll turn into one of them intellectuals, you know, with glasses.
We end up one of those quiz programs on television.
Mason, come with me.
What for?
Just do as you're told. Detective Lang has some more questions he wants to ask you.
Some more questions? Same ones all over again?
Poor kid. Totally clueless. She's headed for trouble one way or another, what with Bennett and that copper friend of hers hounding her in here and her so-called friends on the outside.
Nothing we can do about it.
Yeah, well, I've got a few ideas. Come here, you too, Lizzie. Now, listen, is Eddie cooking today?
Yeah.
Right.
Aren't you getting a bit tired of my visits, Mason? Now, why don't you just tell me what I want to know,
I don't have to.
Oh, no, you're right, Stu, you? Well, let me tell you, in here, you've got the rights we say you've got, and that goes for outside, too.
Mason!
I'm sorry.
Watch where you're going now.
He keeps pumping me with questions. They're trying to frighten me.
What's going on here?
Just a routine inquiry.
Everything is quite regular.
Marilyn doesn't seem to think so.
She's being her usual uncooperative self. Detective Lang here had to speak firmly to her.
I thought police procedure required the presence of a policewoman at any interview.
Oh, blimey! She's going on about her rights and you're throwing procedure at me?
Procedures are made to be followed.
I'm here. It's quite all right.
You stay, Mrs. Jackson.
Well, perhaps that's a good idea, since the prisoner seems to prefer it.
The prisoner?
Well, what possible difference can it make?
All right.
Well, I've got better things to do.
Now, shall we go to the interview room?
Bob and Jill go for a I don't know that word.
Break it into two parts.
Piss-ness.
That's a bit rude.
Look at the picture.
Picnic.
Right.
I'm tired.
Giving up.
Bull. My head hurts. You reckon you're any better if you can read?
Let's just say it comes in handy.
Never thought so when I was little. Left school when I was 11.
How'd you manage that?
Dead easy. Mum and Dad couldn't give us stuff. Not that they're too keen on school anyway. Then I sort of had to stay home. Dad used to get on the sauce and come home and smash everything, including Mum and Gary. I'd have to protect them. Had a dirty great pick handle under the house. And when he got really bad, I'd go for the cops. True.
Yeah.
Well, there's no money coming in, so I had to go and get different jobs. Kind where they don't ask your age. Gary always went to school, but I'd give him a clip under the ear if he tried to wag it.
Didn't the school check up on you?
Nah. You know what they're like. Doyle's more trouble than she's worth.
Really give them bastards a hard time. Looking down their noses at me and Gary. Teachers wouldn't feed them.
I'm a teacher, Franky.
Yeah. But you wound up in here.
Yes, well... Bob and Jill go for a picnic by the...
creek.
Franky, it starts with R. Look at the picture.
River.
Beats me why you bother with all that tidying.
I just think it looks nicer, that's all.
So who's going to notice?
Look, where do you think Doug and Bernie are?
They'll come back when they're ready. It's none of our business.
Don't you want to know where Bernie is?
It's not usually all that fascinating. Look, Lynn, I'll give you a tip about men. They're just kids. You've got to make them think they're on the loose. If you give them a third degree and they come home, they'll just get shirty.
That's not true. My father always said where he was and when he'd be back.
I've heard there's blokes like that.
Besides, I don't want Doug getting into any trouble. He's got to start thinking about getting a job.
A job? And you think Bernie might be leading your Doug astray, eh? No use worrying. Just should enjoy life while you can. If you get done, tough. What's a few months in the pokey?
You'd know, I suppose.
No, not personally, but I have heard.
Heard? I've been there, love. Well?
Complete waste of time. Well, thanks for nothing. You know, I nearly cracked that girl.
The way you were threatening her, she would have said anything. Now, you know exactly what would happen to her on the outside if you spread the word around the parlors that she'd already talked.
What, you think drug pushers are a good thing, eh? Eh? I mean, you think they're all right, do you?
Don't be ridiculous. You have no right. Now, ethically...
Don't give me ethics. You think you're pure or something working in here?
Perhaps I'm not as desperate for a promotion as you appear to be, Sergeant. But as long as I do work here, I'll report any further intimidation to the governor.
You are on the side of the crims. You know that?
Detective Lang.
I'll see you later.
What are you playing at, Meg?
I'm doing my job. What are you playing at? Is there something between you and that detective?
What's it to you?
You've been softening up Marilyn so that that character can get what he wants out of her.
I resent that.
Resent it as much as you like. You know perfectly well that that volleyball incident was an accident.
Who told you?
I heard. Now you better ease off or I'm going to have to report you.
You'd be sorry.
Don't threaten me, Vera.
Hello, Marilyn, love. You look down in the dumps.
Oh, get away, Lizzie. I'm not in the mood.
But I've got a surprise for you. You'll like it. It's lovely.
Well, what is it then?
What if I told you? Wouldn't be a surprise, now would it?
Righto, B, where's the problem?
Is there a problem?
Oh, don't be smart, B. I was told one of the switches is playing up.
No, love. That was just to get you in here. We've got a nice surprise for you.
Yeah, well, some other time. I'm not interested. Hey, what is this?
You'll find out.
Well, what if I don't want it?
Then we'll break your arm.
Yeah, you probably would. All right, let's see it.
Just bucking about. How's your reading going?
Franky, how about finishing this last page?
Nah, that enough for today. Too much bloody noise down here. You can't hear yourself think.
Oh, hey, Lizzie, you still there?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you just keep your hair on and wait for your surprise.
Listen, I know what you mean. Would you like to take the book away and have a look at it by yourself?
Yeah, all right.
Hey, Franky. Now you're getting into reading, you might like to borrow some of me comics. I got some beauties.
Comics? Only morons read comics, Doreen.
This better be important, B. I got work to do.
Yeah, going all conchy. You used to have all the time in the world.
Hey, what? Hey!
What are you doing here?
What's my idea?
I got nothing to say to you. You're wasting your time.
You two better start talking to each other because I'm not letting you out till you come to your senses.
Matchmaking, B?
You might say.
I'll pick it up later.
Hi, Dallas. Keep the home fires burning, girl.
Where have you been?
Oh, around and about. What's up with you?
She's been like that all day.
Well, of course I've been worried. I bet you've gone and done something stupid.
Has he what?
I knew it.
No, don't listen to him. We're going to celebrate.
Why? Did you get a job?
Yeah, I'll give it a break. No, I don't reckon I'll tell you if that's how you're going to carry on.
See?
What do you reckon, Bert? I tell her?
Well, it might get her off your back.
All right. We went down to Births, Deaths and Marriages place and picked up this bit of paper which they reckon you've got to have. See? Now, do you want to get married or don't you?
Looks to me like she'll give it a go, Dave.
I reckon.
I can't hear a thing. What do you think they're up to?
Perhaps she's wrung his neck.
Oh, no. They'll be making up now. Real cosy.
Yeah, I hope so.
I know you've been in solitary. You can't stay out of strife for 5 minutes, can you?
It's not my fault. It's that bloody Vera. She and her boyfriend are out to get me.
Yeah, I know all about that too. So why don't you just tell them what they want to know?
Oh, yeah, simple.
Well, why don't you?
Because I'm not lagging on my friends, that's why.
Friends? Come off it. You've never been involved with drugs. I mean, I know you. You went back on the game, sure, but even you're not dumb enough to push drugs, are you?
No. But I know who is.
So tell them.
And end up floating in the Yarra. Use your brains. Lady, I'm in a hell of a mess. Either they're gonna get me in here or get me out there. Either way, I've had it.
You'd like a real wedding, though, wouldn't you, Linny?
Be nice. Flowers, church, bridesmaid, white dress.
Champagne and big black cars.
And speeches, presents. I had a cousin did it once.
It all costs a bloody fortune, of course.
And they wouldn't let me go down the aisle like this.
Hey, it doesn't matter. We're going to do it.
He's keen, Lynn.
So am I. But I don't know, the idea of a registry office just doesn't appeal.
Yeah, gave me the creeps when Doug and I was there. Like being in the clink.
You knew it reminded me of something.
Well, what do we do?
Hey, what about one of those, what are they called? Marriage celebrationists?
Celebrants, that's the idea.
Well, we could do it here.
Oh, good on you, Suze.
When'll it be?
Oh, well, we've got to have the papers for a month and a day. Mm. That's the law.
Oh, the law.
I can't wait too long with this getting bigger every minute.
Yeah, can't have the baby born with a broken arm.
Hey?
Holding on till after the wedding.
You're a real card, mate.
This is serious.
Oh, sorry. Well, hang on. Well, that's what you can tell them. That the bride's going to drop a pup any minute. It's a bloody emergency, see? I bet they come at it then.
Yeah, well, we can't have the poor little fella born a...
A little bastard? No way. Well, go on, get on the phone, mate. See what you can do.
Do you think it'll work?
Well, leave it to me. Celebrants.
Suppose I'll never learn.
Well, you would if you'd give yourself a chance. Why'd you run out on me?
The way you were going on, I thought you were glad to be rid of me.
Look, we had a fight. You know, we say things to each other, but... Well, if everyone shot through after just one fight...
No, it was more than that. I really hurt you when I gave you that watch, didn't I?
Yeah.
You never trusted me again.
Well, do you blame me?
Well, yes, come to think of it. You were the one always going on about trust, and yet you watched me like a hawk.
I told you I only went back on the game once to get you that present.
Yeah, but you lied to me.
Only because I loved you.
Look, do you think I like the idea of other blokes touching you?
Suppose not. It only meant something with you.
So what are you going to do when you get out?
Have to see.
Yeah.
But I'm still not lagging on my friends.
Yeah, all right. But I was wondering whether you'd give us another chance. I mean, there's a lot of things I didn't think about.
What are they saying?
Shh.
Well, they're saying a lot, but it's too soft to hear.
Yeah, good. Good.
What are you three doing there?
Taking a break.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I don't suppose any of you have seen Marilyn
Mason. No, not lately.
Come on, B, let us out.
Yeah, B, we've done our time.
Mrs. Jackson.
The same. Eddie, get back to work and fast. I don't want to know about this.
Yeah, right, Mrs. Jackson.
Sorry, love. Door must have jammed.
Never mind. I want to see Marilyn alone. You had a pretty rough time of it this morning.
Well, I'll leave.
Well, I think you should report any further intimidation to Mrs. Davidson. I'd be happy to back you up.
No, I'm not going to do that. I've changed my mind. I'm going to tell that cop everything he wants to know.
Lang speaking.
Graham, Vera.
Ah, Vera.
I'm not interrupting anything, am I?
Well, tell you the truth, things are a bit hectic, yes.
Well, it's just that we didn't set a date for our next evening.
Oh, yes, that. Well, I am a bit snowed under here.
Oh, that is a pity. Oh, by the way, Marilyn Mason.
Yeah?
Well, I've managed to convince her that it's in her own best interests to talk.
Are you sure?
Of course. Now, is it quite impossible for tomorrow night?
Well, yeah, actually, all work and no play, eh? But I'll see you before then when I come in to see Mason.
Fine. Until tomorrow then.
It is Bob's birthday. Mother has made a cake.
Everyone.
Yes. Brings Bob a present. Grandmother and grandfather come for the party. Everyone wishes Bob many happy returns.
Oh, Franky, that was terrific. You must have really worked hard last night.
I'm doing good, eh?
You're doing very well.
Yeah, I'm doing well.
Look, shall I read for a bit and you follow? Bob blows out the candles and makes a wish. He wishes for a pony. Even Jip the dog has some cake. There are lots of good things to eat. There are... No, Franky. No what? You know what?
You bloody little tease! You've been leading me on!
No, I wasn't!
He really means it. He'll give it another go.
Yeah, and we're really gonna work at it this time.
Tell you, she's a write-off. All this reading can't make any sense out of her.
Poor thing.
Poor thing. Never mind her. How am I gonna get out of here?
He's a really good bloke.
Yeah, and don't you forget it. And take my advice. Get married. Well, well, well. Here's trouble. The student's back.
I want to know who's going to help me get out of this dump.
Oh, you're a desperate woman again, Franky.
What?
Oh, never mind. I'll be in it.
Me too. I want to go with you.
All right, just as long as we get out.
Come in. Morning.
What can I do for you?
Please, can I talk to you?
Yes, of course. Is there anything wrong?
Franky, I've made a complete mess of things.
What happened?
Well, I was teaching her. You know, your idea. She was doing really well. Trying so hard to please me. Most teaching's like that. Oh, I should have known.
She got a bit carried away.
She tried to kiss me. I slapped her. She stormed out. The trouble is, when she calms down, she'll probably want to go on learning. She's got a brain in her head, she will, but...
But?
Well, I couldn't. I know why it happened, and I know it'll happen again.
Look, you can't stop now. I don't mean with Franky. There are others you can teach.
You really are determined to rescue me, aren't you?
Yes, all right, I admit it. But you admit something, too. You enjoyed teaching again, didn't you?
Yes, I did. Do you think there are others...
Look, I'm sure of it.
Will it be all right?
It'd be easy if you weren't so friggers. But it'll be all right. Calm down.
Are your hands shaking?
Haven't had a drink yet, have I?
Thanks for your help, Suze.
Oh, it's all right. Don't have a wedding here every day.
I wish my mum and dad could have been here. They don't even know where I am. Doug and me, we just up and left, didn't even say goodbye. I wrote them a letter and everything, but it isn't the same, is it?
Don't know. Oh, look, they'll come round, you'll see. You'll be a married woman. No arguing with that.
I hope not.
Turn round.
Oh, I'm so nervous.
You gotta be. That's sort of the rules of having a wedding.
Reckon you're for the high jump now, mate.
Yeah. Haven't got a crack out of me name, of course.
No. Hope yous don't regret it, that's all.
Oh, thanks, Bernie. You are a real mate.
I was just thinking...
No, I don't want to hear about it. You're not going to talk me out of this. That chick in there is tops with me.
No, I was thinking there's this nice payroll snatch I got in mind. We could knock it over blindfold.
Yeah?
Not too far away. Word is there's around $4,000 in it. And only this toothless old coot on duty. No dogs, nothing.
Yeah, well, if it's that easy, then why hasn't some other joker taken it?
Just thinking of your financial situation.
Nah. Now, Lynn would go off her brain.
Well, what are yous getting married for, eh? Love, honour and obey, that's the words they read. She'll have to go along with it.
You reckon?
Well, it stands to reason.
Yeah, I'll think about it.
This kid used to bring things to school. Once a frog, very alive. Another time a bird, very dead. But he always said, this is a present for you, miss. I'm raving on, aren't I?
Yeah, go on. I'm expecting Lizzie any minute, but until then. You really enjoy children, don't you?
I'd have to.
As I remember, you used to want children of your own. When you and I would... I think it was six.
Yes, well, it seemed a nice round figure at the time.
And then you got married, but no children.
No, I came close.
Sorry?
Nothing, nothing.
Miss Bennett said you won't see me, Doc.
Yes, that's right, come in.
Well, I'll be on my way then.
Now, Lizzie.
Couldn't you make it some other day, Doc? I'm very busy today.
Busy? Well, doing what?
Well, this new furniture's come in and the girls are shifting it and I want to do my bit.
Yes, get on the couch, please, Lizzie. I think you know why I want to see you.
Yeah, the old ticker. But I've been feeling 100% lately, promise.
I think I'd take a look at you all the same.
Oh, fair go, Doc.
On the couch, Lizzie.
This is an enormous repair bill. Five chairs, $20 each, $100. One new bookcase, $35. Franky certainly throws expensive tantrums.
You promise you won't let on who told you all that stuff?
Oh, you have my word on that, Marilyn.
You can go now, Mason.
happy now?
Oh, my hair's too right. I mean, with this little lot, we'll be having a few arrests tonight, won't we?
Tonight, but I thought...
Oh, yes, our date. Look, I'm afraid that'll have to wait. I mean, I've got people to see, the report to get started on. You know how it is.
Well, tomorrow night, then.
Well, I'm not sure. Look, I'll call you, OK? Cheers, at the time, I've got to run.
But when?
No, look, really, I've got to go. See you.
One ping-pong set, $6.70.
Marriage, according to the law in Australia, is the union of a man and a woman to the exclusion of all others and voluntarily entered into for life. Now, Douglas and Lynette have asked me to read the following as an expression of their feelings. Joining hands in love to sail the stormy sea of life, God will be with us through any kind of strife. When troubles come, we won't forget that we are man and wife. I pledge these things to you.
I pledge these things to you.
While we both shall live.
While we both shall live.
Good. Now, do we have a ring? Repeat after me. With this ring, a token and pledge of the vow.
With this ring, a token and pledge of the vow.
And covenant now made between us.
And covenant now made between us.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Come on, B, don't take all day.
Come on, B, it's terrible.
Where do you want it, Mrs. Jackson? Hey, I'm in the bookcase.
Really, B? Over here. Come along.
Over
goes
there.
Up. Pick it up. Pick it up.
Come on, Mum. Over here. Where's bloody Lizzie now?
She's in the garden resting. It's Dr. Doreen.
But, Doreen, you're blocking the doorway.
Oh.
Muriel, will you stop playing with that ping-pong set and lend a hand? Get this in.
Right, O.B.
I can take care of yourself.
Having the day off, Lizzie.
Doctor's orders.
Time to go, Lizzie. You just look at your vegetables, Mum. You can go without this.
Come on, let's go.
You little beauty, Lizzie.
Come on.
Oh. Get a move on, Lizzie.
Come on, get that leg out.
Oh.
Come on.